Brick, Morrick, your brick breaks our disease. Well, that's all right then, because I assure you, I give little Baldrick a jiggle under the tap every other birthday. The simple fact is, Baldrick, that you, like the rest of the public, ran up debts for numerous luxury items, such as fuel and food, that you could not possibly afford to repay.
Yes, I did, sir.
You are, in fact, feckless.
I certainly am, sir. I haven't had a feck since our last holiday in Wales.
You borrowed and you borrowed. What led you to this outrageous irresponsibility?
You did, my lord, and those nice people at Melchett, Melchett and Darling. You took my small savings, then tempted me to borrow more with your glossy brochures, smooth talking and a free ballpoint pen.
There we have it, Madam Chair. For the sake of a biro, he and millions like him allowed us to impoverish the nation. We, the bankers, are the victims here. The victims of a public who put their faith in people who are manifestly only interested in their own enrichment.
Are you suggesting, Lord Blackadder, that we blame the public for the entire financial crisis?
That's exactly what I'm suggesting.
That would absolve the government and the whole financial sector of all responsibility.
Well, I don't wish to sound impertinent, but duh. My God, it's brilliant. It is brilliant. It's so brilliant, it would win a place at Oxford, even if it had a northern accent. But it might be simpler, rather than blaming all the public, which could prove unpopular, I suggest that we simply blame Baldrick.
What?
Make him the scapegoat. Traduce him. Pillory him. Strip him of his trousers. Roger him with the speaker's gavel. And let's just move on.
But supposing, my lord, I had a cunning plan.
A cunning plan? To correct the inherent weakness of unregulated markets, which must lead inevitably to the enrichment of the few.
Yes,
the
my lord.
Exploitation of the many.
Certainly, my lord.
A cunning plan to force those predatory exploiters finally to come to terms with their destructive greed.
Yes, my lord.
Well, that would, of course, be brilliant. Do you have such a plan?
No, my lord.
Your witness, Madam Chair.
Society must be avenged. Bend over, Mr. Baldrick, summon the marshal at arms, and bring me the speaker's gavel.